Sveiki, mėlyje Žalgiris TV žiūrovai, kaip ir prieš kiekvienerės EuroLeagos rungtynės Žalgirio arenoje, mes turime tiesioginę transliaciją iš prie pat aikštelės ir šiandien Kauno Žalgirio ekipa susitinka su Atėnų Panathinaikos ekipa, kurioje rungtyniauja Lukas Lekavičius. Šiandien Žalgiriui reikia iškovoti būtiną pergalę, kuri leistų lengviau kvėpuoti turnyro lentelėje. Tačiau prieš rungtynes mes visų pirma kalbame apie dvikovą su įdomiais pašnekovais ir šiandien mūsų Žalgiris TV studijoje svečiuojasi NBA komandos Milwaukee Bucks skautas ir buvęs žalgirietis Kornelis Davidas. Hello Kornel, nice to have you here.
Hi, good evening for everyone and let me say the first thing is I hope I bring the luck for my former team and the losing streak is gonna be over tonight. Yeah. And hopefully this win, I can help you from some spirit to get this in tonight.
Nice words to start a conversation. So, basketball brings you here to Lithuania, as we discussed, yeah?
Absolutely, as like always. You know, I come for several times. I love to come back here. Great atmosphere. I think it's the best arena and the best fans over here in Kaunas. And I'm always looking for the young talents. And Lithuania is always packed with young talents.
Is there someone to watch in this game for you?
Nothing new, because I have been following these guys, you know, for a while now. Zalgiris guys, and obviously Panathinaikos players as well. So it's nothing new, but I still want to see their progress, how they, you know, playing the different situations. And it's now a tough time a little bit, because a losing streak is not good for a moral. But some guys are stepping up in that situation. So I hope it's somebody, because I'm still cheering for Zalgiris, obviously. Hopefully somebody can step up, maybe a young guy.
Yeah. You already mentioned about that losing streak. In your opinion, what were the key reasons behind that four-game losing streak for Zalgiris?
Well, I haven't been here for that many games, obviously, but I tried to watch as much as I could. I think, first of all, it surprised a little bit for me. The home court advantage was so huge in the last year. This year is not so much. Obviously, injuries affecting the result big time, you know. It's always shaking some pieces out. And I think it's what I see is so many unforced errors, like turnovers, who can kill the team even if it's up, you know. So I think those things they manage, and the boards, the rebounds, they can manage tonight. I think they have a chance even if they have two new players.
Of course, as a player, you've been in situations where a club has a lot of injuries. How to avoid that bad character that could haunt the team when their injuries happen?
Well, always, I think in a short term, for 1-2 games, maybe a good opportunity for the guys who haven't played too much to step up. But I think the collectively, they need to step up for everyone to step in the shoes who's missing. Obviously, a better player missing is more difficult to step in their shoes, and especially in long time for games. There's so many games, less practices. So the guys, I think, who's playing now more, they have to learn on the fly. They don't have practice to recalculate everything, because travel games, you know how it goes in EuroLeague, that day. So it's difficult. But I think that collectively, if they start building something, small things, not like, you know, not everybody has to score 20 points or something, but like loose balls, 50-50 balls, rebounding. So small things could help small success can build for the winning culture.
Both of the teams, as Žalgiris and Pau, need this victory to climb up the standings. Will it add some kind of emotional and psychological pressure for both of the teams during this game?
Yeah, it's so much pressure for Panathinaikos. Obviously, they bring in players and bring in new coach, which is really, really good coach. But I think Žalgiris is at home. They don't have to be afraid for anybody. I think they are capable, if they're playing the right way, they're capable with anybody. It doesn't matter if it's a CSKA, Real Madrid, Panathinaikos or whatever. So I think that's the spirit they have to bring back. Okay, they had some losing games in the past, but right now, just like a new beginning, start for the get-go, jump ball, and start to beat them, play physical, and I think a good thing's gonna happen.
Coach Pitino, when he stepped for Panathinaikos, he said that we're gonna play with less plays during the game. Is it the long-term decision or only for a short-term decision to make a team good in a short run? What do you think?
Well, he has a tough things to do, because just like I say, they have not many practices. But also you can see a couple of things which he really good at it, like pressure, yeah. Defense. They try to trap the guys, trap the players, get the ball out of their hands. You know, always in the passing lane. Small things can be changed. They have to change. I think that's the main thing right now for Žalgiris to to concentrate for those things, the passes, the small things, just like I said, to build something, confidence against them. I forgot what was the question originally. What was the question?
About the place. Forget about it. Yeah. Okay. Let's talk about big guys in Zalgiris. You, as a former big guy on the court, what do you think about those guys as Brandon Davis, who seem to step up when injuries happen?
I think Brandon Davis is a key factor this year for Zalgiris. I think a little bit too much a key factor. If he's playing great, I think the team is start follow his up. But Zalgiris is always as good in so many players can step up, you know. So I think the big guys, especially against Panathinaikos, because they were struggling in the rebounds, you know, they have a chance to not just box up, go get the ball, because sometimes the box up takes too much time. Just go see the ball and go grab the ball, because if they have an advantage of quickness, using the quickness to get those balls, they have much easier to go for an offense. I think controlling the rebounds is the key tonight.
Zalgiris has a newcomer, Dion Thompson. In your opinion, how long does it take? How many games does it take for a newcomer to blend into the team system?
It's obvious. It depends on the players. It depends on the situation. It's always a practice time, no practice time. You have to learn on the fly. But those things, what I talk about again, the rebounds, hard play, defense, those things they have to do right away, because that's just a mentality. If you have motivation to do that, he has to do that. Obviously, the system, how they play, there's always repetition, which comes for a little bit later. But those things in defense, I think it's important to adjust quickly and fight for every ball.
As we discussed, Pau has some troubles in terms of rebounding. The newcomer, Dion Thompson, is good at it. It seems that he was good at it during the Spanish league. Do you think this newcomer could already be an important addition for this game against Panathinaikos?
They have to. I mean, he has to step up. It depends, obviously, Sharas, how many minutes he can give, because he can see when, you know, when in the court, step in the court, how his approach going to be. Obviously, he's hyped up because, you know, it's a game, it's, that atmosphere is always, you know, brings the best of the players. But I think all the bigs has to step up today, not just, you know, allowing just one guy, because everybody expecting Davis playing a good game. But it's so difficult for him because the other opponents are preparing against him, just like other guys. So I think it's collectively, just again, I'm repeating myself again, collective jobs can bring the success.
Knowing the situation in the standings, when Zalgiris is right now in the 13th position, but so close to the 8th position, do you see this game as do or die game?
I think it's too early. It's too early to say that. There's so many games left, you know, and every game is important because of the standings, but some things can fall, some things can, you know, rise up and later of the next few weeks. So I don't think so. It's a do or die game, important game, because play at home. And just like I said, winning at home is always important. That's to build confidence. So that's why it's important. But I don't think so. It's a do or die game.
So Kornel, as we know, you're going to be supporting Zalgiris, yes?
Of course.
All right, so we wish you a great game. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much.
Čia buvo Kornelis Davidas, su kuriuo mes kalbėjome apie būsimas Eurolygos rungtynės tarp Kauno Žalgirio ir Atėnų Panathinaikos. Palaikykite žalgiriečius labai svarbiose rungtynėse. Na o ką, mes laukime žaliai baltų pergalės. Iki, mėlėjai.